Okay, class, good afternoon. Let's have another example for a band stress. You have this problem at 260 millimeter by 560 millimeter reinforced concrete beam uses 10 mm diameter stirrups spaced at 250 millimeter OC, or that is on center. If concrete cover for longitudinal bars is 60, have the cover for the main bar, FC is 11.45 megapascal, and FC prime is 21, and then FS is 138. Find letter A, the resisting shear stress of concrete, letter B, the resisting shear stress of stirrups, then letter C, the maximum shear stress that the beam can carry, and letter D, you have the maximum safe load P if or that can be applied at the midspan of a 6 meter simply supported beam. So neglect the weight of the beam. So neglect the weight. So you have this, a simply supported beam. You have with a 6 meter length. So simply supported, you have a hinge and a roller support for the support reactions. You have vertical and horizontal. For horizontal, that is equivalent to zero since you don't have any loads horizontal or acting forces horizontal. So, and also you have for RC, vertical load for the ruler. So this is a symmetrical loading, so therefore your RA and RC is equal. So that is P over 2. Okay, so let's have the solution for letter A. You are to solve for the resisting shear stress. So shear stress is equal to the V allowable. So V, small letter V, that is the shear stress. Big letter B, that is the shear force. So for the shear stress of concrete, you have V allowable is equal to 0.09 times the square root of FC prime, given FC prime is 21. So therefore you have the shear stress or V allowable equal to 0.41 megapascal. And then you solve for the resisting shear stress of stirrups. So resisting shear stress of stirrups is the B prime. So available formula to solve for the B prime is the spacing of stirrups. To solve for the spacing of stirrups, you have this formula. So formula is S, that is the spacing of stirrups, is equal to AV times FS over B prime, that is the unknown or the shear stress of stirrups, times the base. So you are given a spacing of stirrups which is equal to 250, and then AV is equal to 2 AST, where your AST is equal to pi times D squared over 4. So D is the bar diameter of the stirrups. Okay, so substitute to the formulas. So you have S equal to 250 is equal to 2 pi times 10 squared over 4. You have this times 4. Okay, and then you transpose this one. So V prime, that is the shear stress of stirrups, is equal to 2 pi times 10 squared over 4 times 138 divided by 250 times 260, which is the base of the beam. So you have your resisting shear stress of stirrups equal to 0.33 megapascal. And then letter C, you have the maximum shear stress that the beam can carry. So for the maximum shear stress that the beam can carry, you have your applied V. So applied is equal to, So from the previous formula, you have this V prime is equal to V minus V allowable. But for now, you have the unknown V. So therefore, you have V is equal to V allowable plus V prime. Okay? So this formula. So therefore, you have your V allowable, which is 0.41. Then 0.33 for the B prime. So you have your B, that is the maximum shear stress of beam can carry, equivalent to 0.74 megapascal. So what is the maximum safe load P that the beam can carry, which is the simply supported beam with a 6 meter span? So you solve for the critical shear force at a distance D. So where your D is 500. So to solve for D, you have this depth of the beam or height of the beam minus the cover. Okay? So to solve for D, that is height, that is 560 given the problem, minus the cover, which is 60. So therefore, you have your D equal to 500. So, draw first the shear diagram. So shear A left 0, shear A right, you have going up P2, going up, and then 0 load, so 0 degrees line, or that is a line. And then at the midspan, you have load P, so P over 2 minus P, that is going down, so you have negative P over 2. Okay, negative P over 2 is P over 2. So, no load, so straight line. Then at point C left, you have negative P over 2. And then point C right, that is now 0. So, this is the shear diagram of the beam. At a distance D, you have this V, or the shear force. Critical shear force at a distance D. Okay, so to solve for that, that is equivalent to P over 2. That is not the same as the previous example. Ngayon, you have the triangular loading. So this is just a rectangular loading. So same value for the maximum P. So the value of your V is equal to P over 2. But you have this formula. That is the shear stress. So shear is equal to the shear force divided by the base times the D. You have your shear force, shear stress, which is equivalent to 0.74, is equal to V. You can have this as P over 2 to solve directly for P, or you can just have first the V divided by 260 times 500. So next, you have your V equal to 0.74 times 260 times 500. So therefore, you have V equal to 96,200 Newton. And then you have substitute that to this formula. So V is equal to 96,200 divided by 2. I know you have V is equal to 96,200 is equal to P over 2. So you multiplied 9,600 by 2. So you have 192,000 Newton. That is in Newton. So to convert that to kilonewton, so P.